Hello. So I had a very interesting coaching call with one of my students today, and thought I would just share it with you because I'm sure it's going to be useful for everybody. And the question was how to link a theoretical framework with her findings and the literature review. And this was based on some feedback from supervisors. They wanted to see these three things come together. So in the conversation, we talked about her theoretical framework and how it works and what the components are. And once that became clear, we then talked about how the data that she's gathered from her field work needs to be mapped to that theoretical framework, and the same with the literature review. So let's make it real. Let's say, for example, that your theoretical framework has some sort of levels, five levels, whatever it is, call them A, B, C, D, and E. And each level, let's say you're testing an existing theoretical framework, you're not building your own, and each framework has some certain characteristics or qualities. And in her context, I think it was about leadership, so you might have levels of leadership. And at each level, it's characterized by certain qualities. And that's published in the literature, and she's discussed that earlier on in her document. Now she gets to her findings, and she's identified key themes in her interviews. She's coded all the data, or she's identified recurring themes, and she understands what that data looks like coming out of the interviews. Now she's got a map those dominant themes from the, let's say it's interviews or whatever data it is that you're using. You've got to identify the dominant themes and map them to your framework. So back to our example, if let's say, for example, in level B, it has a quality called X, and all the other levels have other different qualities, and that quality of that component of the framework correlates very highly to recurring or dominant themes in your data, then that's a finding. Then you have confirmed that theoretical framework based on your analysis of the data that you've gathered in your study. Or maybe there's an element on the framework, a certain quality of another level in our leadership framework, as an example, that doesn't appear in any data. And maybe there's a reason for that. Either the sample size is too small and you weren't actually trying to comprehensively assess that theoretical framework, or the theoretical framework is wrong and that's something that they missed, that they thought it was a characteristic of that component on the theoretical framework, and then you come along now with a better study and a better set of data and a better methodology, and you discovered this gap in that theoretical framework. Okay, so that's then linking the data that you've gathered to the theoretical framework. And it's very good to visualize these things and draw it out on a whiteboard or sketch it out on a piece of paper. Then your literature review, you will have done a good scan of the literature and engaged with a couple of sources or a number of sources. And again, some of the literature will present your theoretical framework, and indeed it will be the literature that you've used and found the theoretical framework. Now let's say, for example, that quality of a certain component of the theoretical framework is humility of a leader, and a leader at level B exhibits qualities of humility, for example. Now out of the context of the theoretical framework, humility on its own will have been researched, and people who have done studies on humility in the context of leadership. So regardless of the theoretical framework, because other people will have different theoretical frameworks, and regardless of that, you can identify literature that correlates with the components of your theoretical framework. Again, at that level of the qualities or the relationships between the elements of the framework. Okay, so then, and this is what she was trying to grapple with, in the discussion, in the presentation of her findings, as you work systematically through the whole framework. And again, in my PhD, it was a range, and I created a theoretical framework from minus 7 to plus 7. So it had 15 theoretical codes. And if you look at my thesis, my actual findings section of my thesis went from plus 7 to plus 6 to plus 5 to plus 4. And there were characteristics of each of these that I had discovered in the data and then created the theoretical framework. In this lady study, she's doing a deductive, so she's got a framework that pre-exists, but then assessing that framework with a new study. Same story. Structure your section according to the theoretical framework and systematically work through it, and then identify how well each of those are correlated with data or categories of data in your findings, and how well that is supported by the literature. Because remember, literature is also data. And in grounded theory, you even are likely to have a follow-up literature review after you've done your analysis, because you may have found that you didn't cover all the literature as comprehensively as you should have now that you've developed a theoretical framework, because you don't have the degree of analytical thinking at the beginning of your study that you do at the end. But again, that's for grounded theory, for inductive, when you're developing a theory. If you're evaluating a theory, you should be in an advantage, because you can use that theoretical framework to tick off all the elements of the theoretical framework. So once again, let's say there are 5 levels. Have you found literature relevant to all of those 5 levels and all of the characteristics within those 5 levels? If you've done that literature review, then you start bringing it in to support the discussion in your findings about where you do or don't find correlation with your data. So, a little bit of a tricky subject to get one's head around, but we had a chat. I sent her a voice note. She said she sort of got it afterwards, and I do see this as something people struggle with, to try and bring it all together. And I also do see supervisors asking for this, and hopefully this explanation has made it a bit clearer. So good luck, and remember, it is important to demonstrate how all these things come together: theoretical framework, your literature review, and then of course your own findings. Good luck.